stuck, we're getting in there.
Like, past the quarter, so that's what we're... They might not be on there yet.
And then the ESSC, you know, 2,500. We're talking quiet, you know, no two. I just thought it was a really good call that, hey, it could be two modules instead of doing it quick myself.
Chad,
can you take care of
determining the gas in production?
Absolutely.
Houston, Soyuz crew, we have a reserve time of 52 minutes. That's 5-2.
So I show 11 seconds.
Soyuz crew copies. We are
just based on the HDI, looking ahead, we have a strong suspicion that the leak is in node 2.
So just to make
has us go to node 1 forward, and we are putting that in work. But as I said, the HDIs show that the leak is in node 2, so we can also go ahead into the same phase of procedure.
Go for it.
Tell you what, run with that, I'll get the one out of Dragon.
Okay,
yeah
that's great. I'm just looking ahead at
perfect
equipment retrieval.
I don't know specifically, but it's going to be in this area. After the first run, so once you are in the raft, you guys will be getting out to do your lifts. So forever.
NASA archives forever.
Okay, guys, so the three components we want to remember: get safe, get dry, get fat, right?
Thank you.
good. Hey, you want to reach out?
That's little kid's job.
You need to get him like a bandolier. Yeah.
But that's a great idea.
That's your word.
We've got node 2 hatch closed but not latched, and just IMG.
It's hardware trips.
And Soyuz crews, this is a crew, this is the Dragon crew. Hey, on our way for the hatch.
Done actually.
So 117.313.
Hey, Farmer, thank you. We copy and we are proceeding to do the 5 minute sampling.
We're closing the lab hatch for module isolation in preparation for post fire cleanup.
Emergency perform loop engage primary DLA.
Here it is. It's under this one.
it's not even up and running.
Whenever you bring in. So what we're going to do first, since y'all are already familiar, once they're released, this is the process you go through. It has to choose which face to follow. And my experience, usually it's the one.
I think I set up the camera for robotic ops. It was the first time I came in contact, so you really had to mess with it.
I don't ever remember it.
So. Yeah. Actually, at first we only sent up, I think, four payloads, tried to set an exposure setting that's fixed. This thing also has face detection on it. You'll see the little box.
And then you'll just back. And the shell is going to be free float on it. Okay. Cursor. Here we've got the LTL. Here's node one.
That's slightly important.
Yeah, so here's node three on the half side of the lab.
Different responses, but two places to start total changing. If you would fix it, there are data pieces change if you are mentioned.
So on the Hi-Fi, the bottom of these little caps is going to line up exactly with the bale. Okay. So you'll see it lined up.
And then that's one of the things we're checking those to make sure
it makes to the Lo-Fi. It's here, so we'll see what we do.
The issue is that this is limited. So if you have it on an internal,
what it does let you do is now if you've got to access something, you don't have to worry so much about this. You could reach over and bring this over here.
So we got the inlet side here.
It's not like
that. It's tiny.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
That's the
strip of metal there.
Yeah, okay.
It's going underneath.
I can show you a
look. Diver is
not watching
the camera behind me or something like that.
Yeah.
I don't think it was like a showstopper, but it definitely wasn't as easy as if you're locked back.
Yeah.
Face it that way.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
And EV2 has EV1 left clear. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yeah, I think
that's great.
backside feel okay, Bob? Any bunching?
Just on the, like, right where the plenum is. We can have it.
I've only really played once.
Maybe one's right on the top of it.
Well, Robin did fucking play the.
It's a much smaller map. It only has, like, on Fortnite. Her and Wardlow.
No one.
I think invited everybody but her back.
Can you pull down on that one?
And then I waste all the time to fit the
family. I'm running it. I haven't run
no,
it yet.
No, it wasn't a
I just need to get it for 3 years.
Yeah. Oh, well, now.
Just trying to be committed and into a cycle again.
Yeah.
Bags are labeled too. Knee, lower leg is down. Everything's up on that one.
Okay. Yeah. This new dolphin is like, yeah, the best way to do it is just like turn around. So that his head isn't there. He's like pushing with his line, pushing his hand in and trying to like, you know, put the pieces of the bone back together. And I'm like, oh my god.
It's amazing.
Out
of course.
Oh yeah. My mom did.
So again, the top side, the left hand side is your spear to the left. These are your hardware switches and LEDs. Up here to the right, your open door indicator here. Your door is the top. The window side of here, this is where you should be looking at, but they will be on the left. So these doors put the items located inside. The one to the left will allow you to remove the entire box module. Mm-hmm. If we need to consolidate sample items inside. When you close, again, make sure that there's no bulge. That's very important. The other, they will feel secure. But it will not successfully attach.
Yeah.
Right. So let's pull that out. If you pull that out, there's no numbering here. You'll just have to. Now remember this. When this is in this position, not even opening
as needed. So if they do the bags directly on the needle without that needle guard, but you have to. You of course could clean it additional times a month, but this is the only time. So once a month.
For some reason. So, congratulations.
It is changed from some point. Originally, they didn't do that, it may have been.
Oh, okay. Well, that's why I didn't come in.
We had 8 payloads that we could power up on the express rack. The LED would light up on this. We didn't have on the express rack. And I have another. You did that. What I would like you to do is kind of back it out, and these are captive. See you, and it'll be over that.
Body letting us know that it needs more time or we did too much. So,
correct, we'll just shrug it up and then it unracks.
But I think that's where it all is. And we only have so many cameras on the ground to keep flying, so we got some of the other restrictions.
On that
way, the shutter speed's an f-stop. They moved it from. That usually is not a problem on station.
Because the knob is never there?
Yeah. Because it's never there, exactly.
I thought this was an exposure lock programmed in this.
That is programmed for exposure lock. That's still above.
Above you.
Above these panels.
So it's going to bounce back and just lock there.
Nice white CTBs were there.
Right.
It worked just fine.
Sure. You just would put it like kind of.
Thing on there called rear curtain sink. And that is. Yes. You can see them. I would not do this one with bouncing the flash around. And I'm going to just start doing this with my hands and we'll see what we get.
15.
Okay. I'll start talking again with my hands.
Let's try just moving.
Those will take a second and watch the springs as they release to see when they were having issues. So definitely, after you install the lens, that will have to be in a locked position. I don't remember off the top of my head. It's the LED for power as well. When you record it, it'll turn red.
That's our start? The inside?
Yeah, that's our base to start off with.
Bars?
So those are those bars that I was talking about when we were underexposed, had red.
Tip for exposure adjustment, then substitute for the shutter speed.
Those are new lights that probably go for right now. These are similar to the new lights.
Yeah. Well, I don't even know if it went too slow or too fast.
Probably too fast, right?
Oh, yeah.
That was terrible.
And then, of course, you've got your hand control module on top. And so I just remember to fold it twice. The door, it's not going to lock. Mm-hmm. So you want to just engage that little. All right. Hundredths of a second.
You
may think that the success.
Oh,
And we'll go for the DA. Wait, check. We are receiving readings for CO is 165, HCl is 3.3, and HCN is 3.3. However, there is visible smoke, so we will keep our masks on.
Yeah, and it probably takes about 40 seconds to a minute, and then you'll kind of feel some pushback once it's fully empty.
Okay.
I will stand by the forward of the computer.
Well, my class arrived in 2013, so I can't remember.
But there's also a section for not critical contingency EVA.
During the run,
the jet robotic arm.
Wow. Interesting. Before I get started on kind of the flow of the jet.
Quick question. Yes. When I try.
So strong Velcro, it feels back away from the
hinge.
The hinge side. This adjustable.
Yeah.
I would not ask you on a real day to do that. So let's not do it before.
Yeah. Interesting.
So the release torque is actually the lowest because it's when you get to the end of the run.
Demonstrate on the first hold, but three, one. Thank
you. How much are they?
It's a donation only. So
if we think that we can even do that. I mean, so second leg, I guess. So there makes sense.
Yeah. So we could do like so what I would do is I would file to the initial approach fix.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
I'll put this one back. You rock. How about... And we're 909.
Thank you, sir. Permanently. Checking azimuth and DNA.
What did you think about the placement of Balsama?